In the last video, we computed the determinant of a matrix using the definition of the determinant. In this video example, we're going to take a look at a very useful property of matrix determinants. We're going to work with the exact same matrix we worked with in the last video, the 3x3 matrix A, which is 0, 4, negative 2, 1, 2, 6, negative 7, 5, 0. And we are going, we know from this previous video, we know that the determinant of A is equal to a negative 206. So we have actually gone through this computation previously. What we're going to do in this example is we're going to compute the determinant of B, where B is the matrix 0, 4, negative 2, a negative 7, 5, 0, 1, 2, 6. So this is the 3x3 matrix B that we're going to compute the determinant of. Notice something. Matrix B looks just like matrix A, except equations 2 and 3, or rows 2 and 3, have been swapped with each other. So these two rows have been interchanged right here. So using kind of the row operation notation we tend to do, E2, E3, thinking of equations 2 and 3, these really aren't equations here, they're just rows, but we've swapped those two rows. So just note that. For now, we're going to go ahead and compute the determinant of B just using the definition. I'll do cofactor expansion about the first row. So I'll expand it about that first row. So I'm going to have 0 times this submatrix determinant here, minus 4 times this submatrix here, plus a negative 2 times this submatrix right here. That's just our definition of cofactor expansion when doing it about the first row. And then we can go ahead and simplify this a little bit. I've got 0 minus 4 times a negative 42 minus 0 plus a negative 2 times a negative 14 minus 5. Do just a little bit of computations. 4 times 42 is 168. And then a negative 2 times a negative 19. This simplifies to 206. So that's interesting. Previously, the determinant of A was equal to a negative 206. The determinant of B I've computed, and it's equal to 206. So for this particular example that we're looking at, we've just found that the determinant of B is actually equal to the negative of the determinant of A. So keep that in mind. Let's do another little example. Let's find the determinant of C, where C is this matrix right here. Note that matrix C looks just like matrix A, except two things have happened. It's as if I've taken row 1 and switched it with row 2, and then taken row 2 and switched it with row 3. So it's like two row swaps have been done on A to create the matrix C. So keep that in mind. Let's go ahead and compute the determinant of C just using the definition of the determinant. I'll do cofactor expansion about the first row again. So that will give me 1 times the determinant of this submatrix, minus 2 times the determinant of this submatrix, plus 6 times the determinant of this submatrix. And we'll go ahead and multiply this out. That'll be 1 times a negative 10 minus 0, minus 2 times the quantity 14 minus 0, plus 6 times the quantity a negative 28 minus 0. Do a little bit of simplification. That's a negative 10 minus 28. Minus 168. If we add all that up, we end up with a negative 206. So that is the determinant of C. That's the exact same value we had for the determinant of A. So we found that the determinant of C is equal to the determinant of A. So this is interesting. We're working with essentially the same matrices here, A, B, and C. The only difference with B was that B had one row interchanged. The only difference between A and C was that C had two rows interchanged. The magnitudes of the determinant of B and C were the same. It was just the sign that was flip-flopping around. So this is not a proof. We haven't done a proof here. We've just shown kind of some examples of what happens when you interchange rows of matrices. And we see that the only thing that happens is the sign changes, possibly. So this is not a proof. But in general, the property that we're demonstrating here is that the sign of the determinant changes each time a row is interchanged. So if you have one row interchanged, then you multiply by a negative 1. If you have two rows interchanged, then you multiply by a negative 1 twice. A negative 1 times a negative 1 is 1, and that's why we got back to the determinant that we started with. If you do three row interchanges, that's a negative 1 raised to the third power, which would be a negative 1. If you have four row interchanges, that would be a negative 1 raised to the power 4, which is a positive 1. So this, again, this is not a proof. We're just demonstrating this property through some computational examples. But now that we know this, computing the determinant of C is pretty trivial. We don't really need to do the definition. We just need to take the original number we had, a negative 206, and then multiply it by the appropriate number of row changes, a negative 1 raised to the number of row changes. So a negative 1 to the 2 is a negative 1 times a negative 1, it's 1. 1 times negative 206 is a negative 206. So this is often a much simpler way to compute the determinant of a matrix if you know the determinant of, say, the starting matrix A.